Or juked, I mean.
Yeah.
Are we live?
We've been live. Yeah, we've been live.
All right.
We've been live since eggplant. Since eggplant.
Okay. Chat, how you feel about eggplant?
It's dope.
Let us know in the comment section below.
Okay. Let's get into it. It's been a little bit. What happened? What happened last time? Well, Simo, if you want to put that image on the screen, the last words that were said were, "God damn," because, and that was from Trieu, because he was like, "God damn, what a wild spot to end the session." And now we're back.
Yes, sir.
So what happened last session? Big fighty session. You guys fought a lot. You fought with a former general of Zariel named Olanthius in his crypt of the Hell Riders. You have found, you released a bunch of ghosts and wraiths by means of fireballs and firebolts burning up the papers that bound them to the place they were kept. But now they are free. You defeated Olanthius. He came out of his kind of curse as a death knight, and you started talking to him, and he revealed the location of the it goes by many names: the Citadel, the Scab, the Bleeding Citadel, the, you've heard it called all kinds of things. And also you found somebody named Adim Splendar, who is the only other wraith that's left, and he's currently speaking to Buru. The last words of last session were, "Buru, I know you've been looking for me. It's been so long." And then the session, ended. You also had Yoll and Buru becoming high riders of the Hell Riders, and they were gifted with a banner that they currently don't know what they do specifically, but they know that it has something to do with controlling platoons of undead Hell Riders. And that's where we left off. Does anyone have any questions out of character before we dig our feet into this
session?
Yes.
First one being, I think you did tell us what they did. I think we learned what they did in character. Don't they like summon the Legion? You can only summon the Legion. You can only use the thing once.
That's right. You just don't have the text specifically yet, like for the item.
Yes, that. Yes, but we have been sort of vaguely explained what it does. And two, when you introduce a new character, would you be so kind as to type their name in the Foundry box, just so I know how to spell it, so that I can make sure my notes are not disaster, because I'm pretty sure I've spelled Olanthius's name 6 different ways.
Yeah. I will do that.
Just going forward, if that's not an inconvenience for you.
Looking at my last session notes, I wrote Loanthius. I was just trying to write it fast, I think.
That's okay. That's his.
I'm pretty sure once in here I've written Lamouthius.
Lamouthius.
Okay. Okay. So now would be also a good time, as we're going through this first little bit, to recollect your thoughts about what's been going on in the campaign, because now that this has been dealt with, this is kind of, this Olanthius thing has been built up for like 7 sessions now, and now that you know where the location of the Citadel is, you're going to be in an interesting spot to make some decisions. So let's dig into it. Are there any other questions before we get out our shovels? No? Okay. All right.
What?
And dig into it. No? All right. Buru, you've been talked to. Can we also get some immersion? Beautiful. Buru, Adim says to you, "I know you've been looking for me. It's been a long time." Ooh. Gotta drag that down. "Um, And he carries on only to say that you fight incredibly well. And your position is warranted, it seems.
I never was like this before. I was just born big, I guess. Put into it. And as every day goes on, I don't know, I'm put into it. But your brother spoke of you maybe a couple times. But if you don't know, he passed away. Ever since I don't even know if you knew we left Schult together. But he died shortly after, you know, creating a refuge in the green fields. And I've been there every step of the way. But on his dying bed, he told me to find you. But that wasn't my initial, I guess, how do you say, cause for adventure. Things have happened, and I feel like the world has changed. But he did speak of you. With his dying breath, he wanted me to find you, and unfortunately, I know you're not with us either. I don't even know what this is. We're in hell. I don't even know how you could help me.
Well, you have command over me and my squad. So I will be helping you. And you have and will be helping myself and Grimjaw in both of our deaths. The name of Splendar would not carry on. And nobody knew the glory of Grimjaw and what he stood for. Nobody carried on that legacy. Also, nobody knew the glory of our battle. Us Hell Riders who decided to stay and fight and did not turn our backs. But you can spread that word. You can tell the tale. And you can give us our final glory.
Being a Hell Rider is a great honor, but I'm worried about those I may leave behind committing myself as a High Rider for the Hell Riders. And I know we are not of the mortal plane as we speak, but I guess I seek a better future for those on the mortal plane. That is why I'm here.
And that is why I'm here. How better to protect those that you care for than to protect them from the horrors that arise down here?
That's true. Many lives lost with Altaril. And there were issues with Baldur's Gate. There was issues everywhere. Tons of people fleeing. I guess after what's said and done, hopefully something can be established. Hopefully you can be laid to rest as well. but I seek guidance on what my true purpose is. With Grimjaw gone, his last railroad, his last set of guidance was to seek adventure, to leave this place, to find something better for us. I seek guidance. I have no beliefs of gods or demons. Of course, that's changed greatly. Even in the place that I want to create, there is no pledge to a god. There's nothing. And I'm open to pledge to a god if it aligns with my ultimate goal.
What is your ultimate goal?
To raise and create a safe haven outside of Alterel, another place that people could call home. For those, a home for those who have no home at all.
Certainly a noble cause, one that the Splendor name will be proud.
What god do you align yourself with, Adim? That is a question that's been avoided by Grimjaw. And I'm very curious, as a Hellrider, facing death, surely. What did you believe in?
Well, we didn't really believe in anything. We were like you. But then we saw the glory that came with clerics and paladins as they fought. And as we fought alongside them, we too took up that mantle. We saw the power and the peace that came with the upper gods. You don't have to pick. You don't have to be devoted. You just need to know that what you're doing is right and just. And you have a goal that you can be proud of.
I'm somewhat spiteful of the gods. This crypt where you're left to bear away from the light. It took mortals to save you. Just barely. And you served along god-guided warriors, clerics, and one of them as well. I'm slightly torn because I've also seen the dark side and what power it holds and what influence it has. Honestly, I don't even think there's enough room on this plane or multiple planes for all of us. It will take a lot for me to continue this devotion. But I will see to it to be lawful and good to the cause and do what I deem is correct in that moment. And of course, to clean up horrible commitments I've made, as I did not understand what powers lie in Avernus. that is my main task. To redeem myself from that.
And you will. As a Hell Rider. Fear not. And fret not. Who or what you commit yourself to. Just know that what you've committed to is right and just. I can see that your group, your friends, they have light amongst them as well. And in glorious battle, not only will you bring justice to us, you'll bring justice for your friends that are still living, and you will bring life to those who have been brought down here for death, and you will earn the name Splendar. I'm sure you know Grimjaw would have it no other way.
And I'm gonna get down on both my knees and put my head down.
It's us that will bow to you. Do right by us. Lead us in battle well. Be tactful, be strong, and relentless. Both of you. And he looks to Yoll as well. You too, Tortle. You will help Buru earn his name.
Nod.
And like me, it seems as though you'll be fighting alongside a cleric of Torm as well. And this Weaver of the Arcane, clever enough to free us. You have a good squad, though small. Mighty, strong, and capable. You will all fight alongside Buru, and he will earn his name and his title. Rise, Buru, for Grimjaw. Stand strong. Brother.
And I'm going to get up and just do this. Arm to my chest and close my eyes.
And he bows his head. And he starts fading away.
Don't you need that sync thing?
Yes.
Did you remember it?
No.
Because it's in the garage.
Okay, I'll get it. Okay. I've got some other stuff in there. Okay. Thanks, Mom.
The demon starts sinking.
I'm always down for a mom break, you know that?
Yeah, same. And so he fades away.
Can I?
Yeah, go ahead.
Speak out his name before he fully fades? Does that bring it back? Like,
I'll say he kind of like fades halfway and pauses.
Adim, you said You mentioned you fought alongside a cleric of Torm. Who was that?
There were many. Paladins, warriors. And we're all either here or back in Elturel or somewhere much worse.
Thank you for your service.
And you for yours to come. And he fully fades out. Olanthius turns to look at your group. So what now for our warriors? Two high riders, a wizard and a cleric.
I'd like to suggest something. I feel it important to save Celestial and the Companion. I know it might be a tall task to rescue the unicorn. Potentially deliver it to Archon. I feel that angel, whatever it is going to be a big key in our success. Especially if it has an undying hatred of Zariel. And maybe it can aid our battle at the Scar.
I think you're right. Walking up to the Scar now is going to get us anywhere, if not deep into the ground.
You know, I find it a little strange. So many, even on many, some that serve Zariel seem to know where this sword and scab is. Zariel has no clue.
Well, that is of her own doing. She drank from the river in order to forget. She didn't want to know where it was or who she gave it to in order to hide it.
Oh.
As I said, she can be redeemed. But that's not up to me to decide.
There may be more use for the Celestial than we know. Lanthius, what do you know of the genie that guards the unicorn?
Ralzala. She's powerful. Though if you can dispatch of my previous form, I suppose an earth genie won't be much trouble. Though they have a much different set of tricks.
That I believe.
And I'm sure she can be bargained with. It's not by her own accord that she stays there. Though dispatching her is also an option.
We spoke with Jeannie. Seemed to be incredibly loyal to Zariel. What do you mean, not there on her own accord? She seemed just as excited to be there as any other devil we've encountered.
I'm sure you know that there are devices that would commit someone to a devil against their will. Enough to corrupt them over time, to believe that their commitment was of their own accord.
I assume you're talking about a contract.
It is their favorite way to operate. They don't make friends. They make slaves with those contracts.
Do you particularly know where a genie is native to?
The plane of Earth.
Banishment is always an option. We've got two of them. One banishment doesn't work. We have another. I wonder what would happen to the genie then, but at that point that would not be my problem.
No, though she does keep a small army under that ground of hers.
That's good to know. What does the army consist of?
Her earth minions. Admittedly, I haven't seen them all, but I know they are there.
We thought she was alone. It's also good to know. But still, you get rid of the genie, the minions, I'd imagine. May not be much more trouble, especially with their leader vanquished.
Perhaps. Well then, adventurers, warriors, is the path before you clear?
As clear as it's gonna get.
Then I wish you well. You can't know the service you've done for us. But you will see. We will serve you well. I trust that you'll know when to bring us forward.
I trust you won't let us down when we do.
We are bound to succeed.
And perhaps there is hope after all.
There is. And he reaches out, grabs hold of the banner you're holding, Yoll. And he looks to Buru and he says, Adim will lead the charge for your army, and I will lead the charge for yours. Fight well, and see you on the battlefield once more. And he fades, his essence seeming to flow into the banner. And you now stand in this black, rock, hollow, meaningless shell of a crypt. Totally empty.
Well, I think we should probably take some rest. We can hold up in one of these small rooms. Someone take watch and I still have food. I mean, do we want to discuss everything that's happened? It's pretty clear what we need to do next, but if anyone has something to say, we should do it quickly and have a rest.
When was the last time we rested out of character?
That is a good question. I believe
relatively recently.
Mm-hmm. It was a short rest, right?
You did a short rest recently.
Yeah.
We also slept at the last time I think we slept was at the special market.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
Which since then you went to the unicorn, then you came here, had your fight, like had your walk around, had your fight. I would say you're fine to do it now. You're well within your time frame.
I look a little bit shorter, but it's okay.
Yeah, not by much, though. The drive time, you know. You can't keep track of days anyway, so. Okay, so is that the plan?
Well, the question becomes, how do we knock down that fucking tower?
I think we deal with the genie first. I feel like we've got more to worry about with the genie than the tower.
Beating the genie doesn't do us much good if the tower still stands, though. I'm not sure shoulder checking is quite a plan.
Sure, something Silas and I will have to figure out.
Thank you.
How tall did we say the tower was?
It was 50 feet. I remember that because we did the hypotenuse. 50 feet.
Yeah, we fucking Pythagorean that guy. And remind me how big the demon grinder is. I mean, it's like a 2,000-pound vehicle or something like that, but...
I believe the demon grinder is a bit bigger than that. I'll bring up exactly, but I want to say it's... I want to say it's 8,000.
You don't know what the material of the tower is yet, right? Too far to tell?
It's that similar kind of black metal that you've seen pretty much everywhere.
Oh, it's metal. Oh, I thought it was some sort of stone. That is different.
Yeah, we need some jet fuel.
Yep. Yep.
Nope.
Excuse me.
Okay, that'll do.
At 12,000 pounds for the demon grinder. She's a big girl.
How does this thing fucking move at 12,000 pounds?
She got the best fuel in the world. And outside of the world.
How much is that in kilos? Just under 6,000? That's 5,500 kilos.
What of it?
What weighs 5,500 kilograms?
Eighteen elephants.
Or the tongue of a blue whale.
There you go.
Oh, what the shit?
Okay, are you guys long resting or like what's going on here?
You guys know rhinoceros are like almost 5,000 pounds?
Big boys.
That's nasty, dude. Giraffes are fucking heavy too.
Yes, we're resting.
All right. Where are you going?
Game paused. Hello?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah. Hello?
Oh, right.
Yes?
I want to pet my horse.
Okay. And it obeys.
Could you remind me the context of this horse? Like this is Haruman's horse. Right?
Yep.
The horse that killed Haruman.
This is my
horse didn't die and now horse is buddy with Buru because
this is my main guy Baldon, and I'm going to put out my
fist. Because of the spur. Right?
I put out my fist to fist bump it.
And it clops you.
All right.
Okay, we're making 9/11 jokes and now we're fist bumping horses. I'm fucking out, guys.
Hey, you get back here. Give me the name of the horse again, actually.
Why did it move?
I don't know. It like followed him.
The fuck?
What the?
His webcam. Yeah.
No way.
The fuck?
That's cool. I'm gonna go to Alanthius' room and just vibe out.
Okay. Give me the name of the horse again.
Baldon.
I walked away for dramatic effect and then my entire desk fell over. Sorry, guys.
Baldon and Buru, baby, riding into glory.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, just because when I wrote it out, my notepad didn't save. So anyways.
No worries, I got it.
Okay. So y'all are chilling in here for your long rest?
Yeah.
All right.
Before we do that, I would like to just do a quick surveil of the state the door was left in.
Yes.
Because there are a couple of big fucking cows that came in. And if that shit is open and not closable... I'm not exactly in the state to get a snuck up upon.
You mean the main door, right?
Yeah, like I mean, like over here.
Okay. I mean, it definitely looks like it's certainly like wide open and like pressed up against the wall, but it is not damaged.
It's okay. We got Baldon to watch over us.
Yeah, you can close it.
All right, then let me fucking close it. I'm gonna close the door.
This temple that we're in, is crypt. It crypt? Is it like made by Atlantis? Like he built the whole thing? Or is this like from El Terrell just transplanted here?
Well, you didn't exactly gather that information, but let's do a history check. Let's get a history check.
Just him?
I mean, if you're curious, you can certainly roll as well.
I'm curious. Yoll doesn't give a fuck, though, dude.
Okay, well, if Yoll doesn't give a fuck. 5 total?
23.
Oh, okay.
Fucking bro. Plus minus, so it's a 40 total, so.
Yeah.
23? 13 plus 10.
You can tell just by the stone, like the way things are, it's clearly a... It's been carved out of some sort of magic, so very likely it was birthed down here.
That's all.
Okay.
Wait. Carved out of magic or carved by magic?
By.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, that's not like a nitpicky question. That's like that makes a fucking difference.
It does. By. Okay, you big nerd, so you're going to sleep?
Good night.
Okay. And who's doing what?
I'm going to sleep because I fucking died yesterday.
Okay. So you're all just passing out?
We're sleeping.
Okay.
Where are we sleeping?
It looks like you're sleeping in his little study area.
Sir, close the door.
Pet Baldon once again.
Privacy.
Okay.
Just
close the door. Tell Buru to go fuck himself. Everybody gets a corner.
It's basically just be like, just look at him, be like, you know, just watch out for us. You know, if you hear something, scream. I guess. Actually, if you know we're in danger, let us know.
We should probably just keep watch.
And a horse will wake us up.
This horse, who we've only met twice, and the first time he was trying to kill us.
Is this a hidden door, by the way?
It is.
Sweet. Oh, I'm passing out.
Okay. Anyone doing anything crazy?
Wow. Out of character question. I can't remember if you asked me to attune to the spurs.
I will let you know that in a minute.
Okay.
But otherwise, is everybody going to sleep?
I'm not doing nothing.
Excuse me.
I'm going to sleep.
You're going to sleep, okay.
I'm not going to go to sleep yet.
Yeah, me either.
Okay.
I'm going to cast...
This is just a test, by the way. Okay.
Whoa. Okay, I'm going to cast Augury. It's going to take some time, so.
How much time?
1 minute.
1 minute? Okay. Bruce and who else is not going to sleep?
Brew. What the hell is that?
It's me. I'm sorry.
He's with the cast. Oh my God.
No, I'm not.
Fireball?
I was just testing something.
Jeez Louise.
Hey, I promise I won't bring this up anymore. I just need to say this now because we're in like a downtime. I found this website called Measure of Things when I typed in what weighs 5,500 pounds. Did you know the anchor of a cruise ship weighs almost 25,000 pounds?
Wow.
Makes sense.
That's cool beans.
So, you know, I'm not going to make that joke.
And an elephant, on average, is 13,000 pounds?
Bro, if I kept going after COVID, I could have got there. For sure. Okay. It does require attunement.
All right. I shall spend the time to attune to it.
Okay. And augury is going down. Silas, you're sleeping. Yoll, you are sleeping. I got that right?
Yep.
Here I am.
Yeah, Lemon, you think I don't, you think I'm, what do you think I am? You think I'm dumb? You think I don't hear? I heard immediately. You think I, what are you, what's going on here? Anyways. Okay.
What the
augury
happened?
I don't know.
Augury.
Yeah. I'll get on my little dragon hand.
Yes.
Cast augury.
Yes.
Oh, course of action you plan to take within the next 30 minutes. Fuck. No, I can't use augury then. My bad. I didn't.
Okay.
But I will still cast sending.
Okay.
Give me some time. Buru, whatever you want to do, just do it. I need some time to think.
All right. Gonna, I guess, put the spur in my hand and attempt to attune.
Okay.
I'm ready. Whenever there's ready.
Okay. I mean, we're gonna do yours first, but the attunement, I'll just say, like, so you know, the attunement's just gonna happen, so you're gonna be attuned to it. Mm-hmm. And sending.
Sending.
Yes.
Going to send a message to the celestial plane.
There's okay.
5% chance it does not arrive.
Okay.
I'm sending a message to Lulu. Let me give it a shot. There's a 5% chance it doesn't arrive.
You have to choose the plane that it's going to, too?
I have to choose a creature that you are familiar with.
That's it.
Choose the recipient, okay. You can send it between planes. It doesn't matter where it is. There's
a 5% chance it does not travel through the plane.
And I guess Phrank has to roll a D100.
Yeah. I mean, okay. I'm going to say it. He rolls it, and then I see if a message comes back.
Yeah.
Okay.
The message that I'm going to send Lulu. Hope you are well. You know our party. How do you suggest we free the unicorn from the metal tower it is in?
25 words you get? Okay. It is in. Huh?
Roll the dice.
Okie dokie.
Do You gotta stop making that face as soon as possible, please, and thank you.
Sorry if I caught you off guard, Frankie.
No, that's okay. Sending always catches me off guard. There's no way around it. Because the characters that I know you're interacting with are here in front of you. And the ones that are not, you know, they're elsewhere.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, this is an extra curveball on account of, oh, you know, a she-dead.
Yeah.
Crazy.
She says,
"25 words for Lulu as well."
Okay, she says. Sorry, these are hard. She says, "Hi, Gantash. I wish I could help more. Maybe climb and jump at it? Tell Yoll I said hi. Oh, and see you soon." And that's it.
Buru, just hear out loud. "I don't know why I thought that would work."
Thank God Yoll's not awake, otherwise he'd fucking beat your ass for that saucy comment.
I'm just gonna scratch my head. What? What did you just do?
Just spoke with Lulu.
Ugh. What do you mean? Okay?
What do you mean, oh?
I'm offing because she's dead.
Yes, I asked her for help, for guidance on the unicorn. God. She said we should jump at it, so I don't think that was...
Jump at it?
Great advice.
Jump at it. Wasn't that thing protected by a genie?
Yes, I guess I just mean after the fact. Gantash, like, looks up and says, "Sorry, Lulu. This didn't help very much."
The unicorn's being suppressed, right? Something like that.
Yes.
But nothing's around it. It's just being controlled. Or is it?
It's in prison.
Is it like... So it's... It's like cattle, right?
It's imprisoned by magic, I'd imagine.
And she said to jump at it.
Listen, I wouldn't take her advice at face value.
If anything, that would don't jump at Baldon, I'll tell you that.
I wouldn't
scare the crap out of him.
Wouldn't think too hard, Guru. I don't think it's sound advice.
Jump at it. She's a celestial, you just never know. It could be very innocent slash naive advice.
She wasn't very sure in her answer. Oof. So
I'll remember that. Jump at it.
Or climb it, she said. Jump or climb.
Ugh.
I've done enough climbing in hell. And now I'd like to do a little bit more sleeping. Guru.
Me too.
And you all sleep?
I go to sleep.
Okay. I'm going to say this is probably, outside of the Wandering Emporium, probably one of the more secure locations that you've ever spent the night. It is totally uneventful. You guys make it through with Silas, obviously, coming to first. Though, I do need everybody to make a constitution saving throw.
Oh. 19.
Okay.
David rolled a 55.
10? You got a 10?
Just barely made it. Maybe.
Oh, we'll sorry. See. I was still reading that thing you sent me. Constitution.
Yep.
Lemon rolled privately.
I think he just had it set muted. To that. I think he just had it set to that.
I didn't mean to. It's a 5.
I think you can right click it and set reveal to public.
Yeah, you can public it. So. Yeah,
like public or something like that. Yeah.
Okay.
Everyone who has a less than a 19 gives everyone who has more than a 19.
You all have that
$100 in real life.
You all have the COVID rot that Gantash has been having in his mouth.
Spider rot.
Spider rot.
Maybe that's why Lulu said see you soon.
So Silas, you need 4 hours, right? Something like that?
Yeah.
Okay. At...
Can I do this rest or not?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well, I don't know what's happening. Okay. Is happening during the rest or post? Okay. Yeah,
you get your rest. Silas...
I really get my 99 hit points back.
Silas, you wake up. Is there anything particular you want to do during the time that you're awake in there or not? Fireball.
Yeah, fireball. No. No.
Nope.
All right, no.
Just gonna hang out?
Yeah.
Okay. At kind of nearing the end of the rest, everybody's still in their slumber. You see Gantash, his eyes pop open, and he is wordless, noiseless, and breathlessly choking. It's probably, let's call it like 7 hours, 45 minutes. Everybody's kind of coming towards the end of their sleep, but he is very clearly the first one to wake up. Gantash, you can't breathe.
Okay. I have to give him mouth to mouth?
You can't breathe. So, Gantash, what do you do?
I start like not breathing, obviously, right?
Yes.
You start not and I'm just breathing. It's such a weird way to put it.
I'm just it's choking. Like worse than choking. Your airway is totally sealed.
Do I feel like I'm gonna like pass out from it?
Well, you are currently in like a state of shock. Things, you know, you're obviously like, what the fuck is going on? And yeah, you can't breathe.
While that's happening, I'll rush over to him.
Okay.
I will too.
You're asleep.
Well, you're asleep.
Oh, wait, whoops.
Yeah, you're asleep. You can see that his mouth is actually stuck open. And there is a huge growth of that white stuff keeping his mouth wide open and totally clogging the airway.
As I'm choking, fuck. I'm gonna mind link with him as he comes over.
Yep.
And just scream. So, yeah. Fire.
Fire.
Burn it.
I'm gonna do this quickly. I'm gonna not do fire right away. I'm gonna do prestidigitation and try and clear it. No? Okay.
It doesn't work. Six seconds go by though.
Okay, I will,
just do it.
Try light it. The only thing I have is firebolt.
Just do it.
Okay. I guess I'm gonna cast firebolt in his face.
Okay.
I have a torch, but I don't have a tinderbox.
What do you mean?
I don't have a... Wait, can you light a torch? Just...
Well, it's gonna take... You would take time to strike a... You would need something to light it.
Yeah, I'm just gonna cast firebolt in his face.
In his face?
I don't know.
I mean, the decision's been made. Don't let me turn you around. Wait,
I'm just going to put my mouth as he prepares to cast closer to his hand. So it kind of tries to aim it down my mouth.
Okay.
For fuck's sake.
Okay. I'm going to have you roll damage and we're going to add on. What's that?
Can I clear it with my hand?
You can try anything you want.
I want to try clearing.
Why was your instinct not to try and clear it with your hand?
I don't know. He told me to fireball him in the face.
Okay, so no, as time is ticking on here, you just reach inside his mouth and you just start kind of grabbing at this stuff, and it does pull out. Like you're able to like pull out like kind of globs of it. You know what? Give me a sleight of hand check. Let's see how well you do this. Okay. So you're able, at the very least, to pull enough to kind of, like, get a little gap in, like, the side of his cheek that goes down his throat. And so, Gantash, you do recover some ability to breathe. Though it is a bit labored, it's like breathing through a straw, basically.
Can I try to reach into my own mouth and try to clear some more?
Yeah, you can.
This is fucking... Well, you know what? While they're doing that, I'm going to take a piss.
Okay, go ahead.
It's like a scene from... what's it called? Superbad?
You want me to roll something for... pull it out of my own mouth?
No, you're already breathing, so I won't make you... quite the pressure. I was going to have you make a... You were going to take some choking damage there, but... okay, so
saved him.
Yeah, so you're able to breathe and you're able to like slowly over time just like kind of force it out. And I will say too, like, you're gonna need to like blow your nose to get the stuff out of your nose. Like it's a process. It takes you a couple of minutes, but as it comes out, it's the same stuff as before, but like much thicker, much more well formed. And it kind of creates, yeah, it's like there's more structures to it, though it is still interconnected, and yeah.
Thank you, Silas. I fear I don't have much more time.
At least I didn't cast Fireball.
That would have been fine.
You wouldn't have much time at all.
Would have been okay. I fear this will take over me. I can't stop it.
You know what it is?
I just know that I'm the host. And that whatever is within wants to consume me.
I'll say at this commotion and you guys kind of talking, the noise kind of stirs Yoll and Buru awake as well.
As I notice them start to wake, I'll just kind of, the last thing I'll say as I look over to them, this will not be the last time I will need your help in the coming days.
What just happened?
Oh, what do you mean by that?
I'll just ignore that and say, good morning, Buru. Yoll.
What happened?
You look like shit. I assume.
Yeah.
I'll be fine. I'll be fine. We have a big day. I spoke with Lulu last night. Oh, she says hi.
Choking back tears. Hi.
I asked her about the tower. She said to climb it, but I can't tell how serious she was. You know, Lulu.
Knowing her suggestion after that would have been push.
No, she said jump.
That's worse.
Hope we could always fly.
It's true. Let's get to it.
Crack-a-lackin'.
I have a question about geese.
What?
It's a spell.
Oh, you're right. I was like, what?
Oh my god.
Just nice and random.
So why is their poo green, do you think?
Why do they honk? I don't even know.
Christ. You can't just, I have a question about geese out of nowhere, dog. Shit.
I feel like this has been answered a million times, but it's a verbal component, a 1 minute cast time.
Yeah.
Does the person know that I'm casting it, or is it just kind of being...
They wouldn't know unless they could obviously hear, like they wouldn't like feel it, but any of the components of it, like they would, if they were looking at you, they would see you casting a spell. If they were listening to you, they would hear you casting a spell.
Perfect. That answers my question about geese.
Okay. Okay. The green poo thing I'm not sure about, but that I can answer.
Yeah. Probably all the algae they eat.
Oh, good. Yeah, probably could be. Okay. So are you homeboys heading out?
Yes, sir. I guess so.
Okay.
I guess so.
Are you riding your horse, Buru?
Can we use your horse as a pack mule? Actually, a pack mule following several cars
actually,
is probably
no.
a bad shout.
Only I ride the horse until I gain his trust.
That's what I said.
Yes.
I said, are you riding it?
Yes, of course.
All right. So I'm driving solo.
Stop looking at him.
No, you can drive with
Jimmy Neutron. What's his name?
He's still out there?
Jimmy Neutron. That's it.
Oh, I thought it started with an N. No. I didn't even write down his name because I'm so uninvested in that at all. The whole thing. I pretend like the homunculi never existed in the first place. I'm not interested. See ya. Yeah.
Okay. So I'll have you guys head out. And you step out of the crypt. And at this point, you can see that all of the statues that are on the outside are no longer kneeling. They are standing with their swords at the ready, pointed outwards.
That's fucking sick. Do we get a new title for this area of the map?
You do, actually. Let me reveal that.
I fucking love that. The completionist in me is like, no, we gotta get all the names up on the map.
Fair enough.
I'm pretty sure it's not called Demon Zapper 2. Like, you know, maybe one day we'll know.
No, that is the name.
Zariel needs to be more creative.
Well, it zaps demons. And yeah. Also fiends not of this plane, I believe. Like Bazit couldn't go too close to it because it was also to shoot his ass.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well assessed. Okay. So your vehicles are out there?
Yes.
Both ready to go. And Bazit is laying on the ground next to the scavenger.
Laying on the ground?
Yep.
Is he dead?
He went at nights.
You can sleep in the car.
And he just kind of comes to, and you all just hear in your head, you know, anything's really better than sleeping in Shumrath. So we can, I'm ready. What are we? Are we going in?
You got eyes yet or what?
No.
All right, so let's hit the road, shall we?
Oh, yes. Aren't we going in?
We're done here.
How long were you asleep?
Honestly, I kind of fell asleep on the way over.
Okay. Long time. You've had a rough go of it. That's okay. Remind me to never ask you to stand guard. I guess you're blind, so it would be a bad choice anyway. Never mind. Get in the car. Let's go.
Okay.
You're riding with Silas.
Okay. Also, Buru, I forgot to tell you, but the tack, when you attuned to it, it kind of like dissipated from your hands and appeared attached to the back of whatever shoes or boots or hooves that you have. you have two of them now. They're on the backs of your feet.
Oh my god. Let's just say I have like half hoof, half boot thing going on.
Okay.
It's attached to the boot.
Sure. Okay. Okay. So where are you guys headed?
Actually, will you say that how long has it been since Baldon's been summoned? Because it's 24 hours.
Right. So it's been like
and 9 also hours. The long rest. Okay, 9 hours? Okay.
Yeah.
I don't want him to just disappear while I'm riding him, you know?
Who is going in what vehicle?
I'm with Yoll. Bazit's with Silas. Buru's on the horse.
Okay. Who's driving out of you and Yoll?
Probably Yoll.
Okay. I will say, I'll just kind of give...
Stinker's got to barf up spiders or whatever the fuck he does.
I'll say... wherever you're headed, as you kind of peel away, you quickly realize that the horse is not quite as fast as the cars.
I mean, yeah, it's a fucking horse.
Yeah.
What? This thing was flying.
Yeah, even while it's flying, like it kind of jumps up and flies, it's not as fast as the vehicle.
Okay, well, does the horse fit in the car? He could ride the horse in the car.
Yeah. He could get on the scavenger, the demon grinder.
Fine. For fun, I'm going to be on my horse on the demon grinder.
Okay. The wind whips through your hair from way up there, and it's a glorious feel.
Just on top, just.
And you know when you fan a fire and the flames kind of get low, but they're like, you could tell they're like open? That's what happens to the horse.
Oh my god.
Okay, they're like ready to just go at any second, but they never quite go. Okay, so
as soon as we stop, his mane just.
Yes, exactly.
Is there oxygen?
Actually,
presumably.
Okay, to be fair, I'm not gonna be on top on the horse. I'm just gonna hold him.
Okay.
While we're on top, just enjoying.
I feel like this is like some weird Garry's Mod thing. You're just holding a horse as you're in a car that's moving. Like it's just and it's just T-posing. Like the horse hasn't loaded yet. It's just fucking.
Oh my god. Gotta treat him with respect.
All right, kids, tell me where you're going.
To the Demon Zapper.
Okay. The two drivers of the vehicle, would you please roll me a D12?
We're pretty far from the River Styx, right?
Pretty far. Pretty
and
darn.
It's been one day since we left the Mahadi's. I keep calling it a bazaar. It's not what it is, but the.
Yes.
The thing. In
yes.
One day? Okay.
Yep. I know where your head's at. Okay. 3 and 12. Okay. So I'll say that you guys kind of rip across the landscape pretty well free and clear to get where you're going. And you know where you're headed, so you get there relatively quickly. I'll say about 3 hours pass, and you are at your destination. You see the Demon Zapper from, quite a distance away, and you roll up to it.
Are you keeping track of fuel, or should we be?
Maybe a mixture of both. I've got a pretty good idea, though.
I have a vague idea in that I think we filled the tanks right before we left to go to the Crypt of the Hellriders. I just don't remember how long we drove to get to the crypt.
I'm keeping a pretty good eye on it. I think it was around the same amount of time, so you're about 6 or 7 hours deep into it.
Okay, you're about halfway through a tank.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So you guys rip up. Now, I will say, as you approach, your characters will know very well that Bozzet is not too fond of the idea of getting close to this thing.
That's all right. We'll all get on the horse.
Just fly over the genie.
Can the horse headbutt the unicorn out of the hole?
Pretty powerful headbutt, I must confess.
Yeah, well, the horse kicked its fucking owner to death, so it's a pretty fucking sure. Good horse. It's a friggin' dece horse, dude.
I'll pull over and let him out.
Let him out. We're just gonna
let him sit. He sat outside last time.
I think we left him at least with the car.
We walked.
No, we walked.
I think. No.
Lemon is making me so hungry.
We took.
Sorry.
No, don't apologize.
Some pizza.
Oh, don't show me now. Say sorry. I think
we all got into one car.
Yeah, I think let's all
we discuss.
We can leave the car for Bazit so he has somewhere to relax, I guess.
We at least discuss our rough strategy with this genie.
Yeah, that's a good idea. So the thought was the genie's not actually that loyal to Zariel, more so that the genie has some sort of contract with Zariel. There's nothing we can do about that, because to break a contract, you need to kill the devil who owns the contract. And if the person who owns the contract is Zariel, then that is ambitious. So seems like we have two choices. One is to convince this genie that we're gonna break their contract and free them from it and allow them freedom to live their life as they so choose, should they allow us access to this unicorn, or we chop it and all its buddies into little pieces. That seems like the only other really two options.
Well, there is a third. It's quite viable. Silas and I can banish it. If I fail, he can try again. Two shots.
So we're then we're just they've got a army. Seems bold. I can't imagine there's an army under there. I don't really know what it is. They don't either, but they got something. We're gonna have to, if we do that, we're gonna have to chop some stuff into bits.
But so either
we
easier. Chop
things into, we either use our arms or we use our brains. It's tough.
Let's start with brains. Then if things get hairy, swap to muscle, brawn.
Well, if we're starting with brains, Buru, you and me, we don't talk so much. Actually, you know what, Silas, you shut up too. Gantash, you got it, right?
Sure. I'll do my best.
Just tell me where to jump, I guess.
I'll climb the tower when it comes time.
Let's do this.
Okay, so you drop off Bazet.
Get all
are you guys rolling? You're all on the demon grinder?
Yep.
Okay, horse and everything?
Sure. Depends on Guru. Licks his heels, you know?
Yep.
I mean, we're close enough to the demon zapper that I wouldn't be going full speed to get to the demon zapper.
Right.
You know, I'd be driving at a very fuel efficient pace.
Okay.
Peak fuel efficiency based on the engine. So Brew could probably ride along.
Yeah. If we're not going full speed, I can just be
if you want.
Side.
Sure. Okay, so let's
bring Silas with you, right?
I don't wanna weird out my horse, you know? Like, why does this guy smell rotten?
Sorry, no weirdos on the horse?
Okay. So you find your way up to the Demon Zapper. Big tower, unicorn, all that jazz. Yes. But again, it seems like a totally empty area from where you guys are at. As you roll forward, so you get to about there, you see that familiar rumbling in the ground, and just the head pops out again. What are you doing back here?
What was her name again? Sorry,
Ralzala.
Ralzala.
It was a her?
Yes. Greetings, Ralzala.
What are you doing back here?
We've come to parley once more.
For what?
It's time for you.
You wish to parley for me?
In a matter of speaking, yes.
Explain yourself.
Your loyalty, from what I understand, is to Zariel, correct?
It is unshakable.
And how did this loyalty come to be? I'd like to do my thinking thing, my mind reading thing.
Okay, are you in? I'll just bring her up. Are you in range?
Ooh, it's a good question.
I'm trying to find it, but it's like I can't find it for some reason.
Yeah. I'll just say, like, if you're not
60 feet,
you
can
60. You might like literally just be right there. Oh, barely. I'll say you can walk up 10 feet as you're talking to her.
Read thoughts. Wisdom saving throw.
Beak. Okay, wisdom save.
Love these.
Seems to... Ooh, you might get this one. 14.
Fails.
She fails?
Absolutely.
Okay. So, you get the surface thoughts, right?
That's correct.
You get the idea that as you've kind of asked her this question, her internal response is one of intrigue. Though her outward response is I've chosen to be bound to somebody so powerful.
Meaning, you came here from the earthen plane on your own accord.
There was a task that needed to be done, and I am a good fit. The thoughts tell a pretty different story than that.
Yeah, I have a minute, by the way, just so you know.
Yep. The thoughts kind of, you get a flicker of, like, the signing of a contract and, like, a kind of crippling force, forcing the hand.
It's gonna be fucking Doritos bold right here.
Jesus Christ.
What do you miss the most about the earthen plane, Elzala?
Nothing. The earth here is fine. So bold. So bold. And it's just kind of like sorrow. Home.
What if we were to help you go home?
Give me a persuasion check, and I'll give you advantage because you kind of got a one up on her with the thought reading.
Give you advantage because the music.
Rip, baby! Yes, yes, 26, nat 20, baby.
And she sees, she just kind of like, she brings her whole form out and she has her giant maul and she kind of puts it on the ground and she like spins it in the dirt for a second. So keen. And how do you propose that we do this?
It'll depend on how you are bound to this plane and if our path aligns with that process, which I our end result brings you home.
My binding is not of my choosing. And it's directly to Zariel.
Then our paths are one.
You know nothing of my path. And if you know anything, then you know that my binding is secure.
Is the minute up, by the way? Or is it close to about being up?
I'd say, like, from this point forward, after you've kind of, like...
I wanted to cast suggestion before it was up. I get to cast
it. I'll say now is the time to do it.
Cast suggestion.
Okay.
Free. She has to do another wisdom save.
Don't you just get it?
No, I don't think you
have to do the wisdom save.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure. Like, link the thing, but I'm pretty sure if this one succeeded, you just get suggestion. I'm pretty sure that's what we've done in the past.
Because at the end it says, you can use your action to end this effect and cast the suggestion spell without expending a sales slot. Oh, it automatically fails its saving throw. Oh,
yeah, that's, yeah.
Shit.
So you just get the suggestion.
Okay. What was the last thing she said, sorry?
She said, if you know anything, then you'll know that my binding is concrete. This is like, I feel like I'm at a fancy dinner right now.
Fancy dinner being hosted by a vampire?
Yeah, yeah.
A fancy dinner where you're not sure if you're there for dinner or if you're there to be dinner.
Yeah.
Okay, so. Look.
Yes, yes.
Pretty much.
Because the suggestion has to be kind of crispy too. If it's like too far-fetched, you can say no. I'll just link it just so you can. You know.
Yep.
Well, that may be true. Azala, our desired end result, by default, relieves you of your contract.
Here's what the suggestion comes in.
Help us free the unicorn, and we will help free you.
Told you to like Gantash talk.
When you like Gantash talk.
I'm gonna take a little twist with this spell. You can kind of feel the spell still like lingering in the air. She says, you understand that in order to free me of my contract, you either need to convince Zariel to relieve me of it, or destroy her. Is your plan to do either of those?
Without breaking eye contact. Takes a moment.
It absolutely is.
I'll give you a persuasion check. Spell still lingers. You get advantage.
12.
12?
Aye, aye, aye.
I can only hide for so long. You need to do this within 3 days. And she says, I may be bound to Zariel, but now I am bound to trusting you. And she kind of like picks up her maul and she like waves it from side to side. And these boys reveal themselves, these big lumbering earth elementals.
Dang.
And they all climb up the sides of the tower, and where it arches over, one of them just kind of like, actually they all climb the same side, I should do this right, they all climb the same side, and where it arches over, one of them just kind of grips the tower, the archway, and kind of like sticks its legs out and just totally stiffens itself, and the others just link together to form like a chain to where the final one just the final one just kind of like reaches out and like plucks the unicorn from its stasis, and it's totally passed out at this point. It just, all the energy just kind of dissipates, and they kind of pass it forward, slide their way down, and they bring the unicorn forward to you.
As they're climbing down the tower, I just want to look around and be like, well, fuck. I guess she was right.
I guess she was. And after like looking back to Yoll and seeing that, he looks back at Rolzala. It will be done. I may have a suggestion on where you may hide, possibly.
That is.
The Crypt of the Hellriders. Lanthius. Is our ally.
Three days. That's all I'm going to have. I don't know why you need this, but I can only hope that its use will be to aid you in whatever it is you're planning on doing with Zariel.
We don't pursue a unicorn for whimsy's sake.
And I expect to go home, not just be freed from my contract. I don't know why I'm trusting you with this.
I will see to it.
Then see to it. And they all kind of crumble down into the dirt.
I walk over to the unicorn and evaluate its status.
Give me a medicine check.
Oh boy, this could be good.
It's a 21.
21. It looks like it's basically passed out from like just sheer exhaustion. It's like healthy, it's just
though, right? Like it's alive.
It's healthy. There's no blood, no nothing.
I'll look back to Yoll and Buru. Kind of nod my head over. And as they approach, I'll say, not sure I can lift this thing, but I upheld my end. Bargain.
I'm gonna call. I wanna call Baldon over. Okay. Like whistle.
And it comes up, and as it looks at the unicorns,
I'm sure you guys will be friends.
And it just wanted to be friends.
It just turns around, just like puts its rear end towards the unicorn.
Oh yeah, right. Wait a minute.
You remember actually, what we're doing with this thing, right?
I want to take out just to be sure. The wand.
Okay. And you hold it up, and you move it over, and it's like a magnet. You move it close, and it locks on to the unicorn. You pull it back, you stand closer to Gantash, it pulls to him.
Gantash, you know why we're taking this creature, right?
You think I don't?
Okay, I just... You know, I just want to know how you feel. You know, if this is another way, I don't know, but at least we've
there's
saved
not
it.
Another way. Certainly not one that we can get done in the next 3 days. Stop thinking. Let's go.
All right. I'm just gonna, I guess, help Yoll carry it.
Now, on the measureofthings.com, there's no list on how heavy a unicorn is. What are we thinking?
So it's about the weight.
Say a horse was about 930 pounds.
Yeah, so you're looking in the same range. It's a little smaller than a horse, but about the same.
So we think that I could lift a horse on my own?
No.
What do you mean? That's less than half what, or less than twice what I weigh.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I weigh 488 pounds.
I would say you could drag it by yourself.
I'm not going to drag it.
Okay, well.
Buru, shut up and help me with the fucking horse.
I'm going to help.
He's like, I didn't say anything. Yeah, I know. Shut up. I guess we put the horse on the fucking truck. God, this feels horrible.
Plop it down into the open space.
I would like to go on record and to say that I would like to not plop it.
Okay.
Put it? Sure. Place it? Absolutely. Plop it? No. I have more respect than that.
Okay.
I'm from the land of the monsters. Come on.
You gingerly thud it onto the the bed of the demon grinder. It takes up pretty much all the space on the flatbed part of the center of the vehicle. You have your unicorn. It's breathing well enough, but it is totally out.
How long a drive is it to Harkon's Rise?
We have to go pick up the other vehicle.
Well, yeah, I know, but that's 3 minutes.
Are you asking me? Well, it's hard to say, genuinely, but the last time it was well over 10 hours.
Fucking holy dicks. Although we do have to cross the River Styx. And there is someone I'm looking to meet at the River Styx, if you know what I'm saying.
Actually,
in around 8 hours. We're just gonna take a little detour once upon a time, maybe just kinda. I owe someone a visit.
Are we back to the
Yeah, I'll see. I mean, nobody said anything about your actual actions, but if you want to drive, sure.
I mean, I'm imagining we're getting back to Baza and we're figuring out what we're doing.
You're back to your... All right. Let me bring you up on the map here. Bing bong. There you go. Okay.
I guess I'm gonna get out of the I guess we all kind of get out of the demon. I don't know. Listen, I don't wanna tell people what they're doing, obviously, but I'll get out of the demon grinder because we're all parked here.
Okay.
I would get into the vehicle I drove here.
I'm going to follow Silas into his vehicle.
Oh.
Okay. I'm just going to do the same thing. Demon Grinder. Chill my horse.
Well, you can't get on the Demon Grinder because the empty space is filled with a different horse. Unless that's not correct. But I believe that your horse space has been taken up by other horse.
I mean, he could ride it back to this meeting.
You know what? I'm going to straggle behind with my horse. Can't wait to get lost. Actually, my horse can fly. No way I'm going to get lost. He knows his way around. He was born here.
Native.
I don't think that's true. I think the horse was corrupted in the same way that... Sorry, I'm not taking my own advice. I'm thinking too much.
What's up?
Partners in evil. Oh, boy. Yeah, I'm just going to fly behind for funsies.
We haven't left yet. We're all...
And you're not fast. You're slower.
If, let's say it's a 10-hour drive at full speed, if we slow down to let Buru and his horse keep up, how long? Ish.
So you would be shaving off 10%. So you'd be adding
10%.
You'd add an hour.
Oh, 11 hours.
Yeah.
That's fine. I don't mind adding an hour.
Okay.
I mind adding an hour to an hour, adding an hour to 10 hours. Diminishing returns and all that.
Yeah. Okay. I'm just going to get your horse on the screen, too.
Oh, wait. Are we moving?
Nope. No, we're not moving yet.
Oh, okay.
Turn to Gantash. You look like you have something to say.
In time.
This is a weird time to decide to hold your tongue.
Didn't expect to get the unicorn that easily. I guess not that easily, but we are one step closer. Now there's much to be done.
We just gotta kill Zariel in 3 days.
Yeah, no big deal.
No biggie.
We have to free the contract in 3 days.
It's true.
Different. Alanthius thinks that Zariel can be redeemed. Maybe.
This.
Maybe.
Celestial.
That is true.
Companion could do that. It might be powerful enough. if it wants to after being tortured for 70 years.
Those the homunculus? Get these fucking snot rockets out of here.
I just wanted to get a full vision of everything that you've got going on here. This is a wild ride, boys.
I'm literally leaving my homunculus here.
You're gonna leave it?
Yeah. It's already started like drooping and fucking melting. It's also made out of Shumrath, and that's fucking gross.
That's like ordering an ice cream and just because it starts melting in your hand, you just throw the whole thing out.
No, because ice cream is delicious. This is fucking a snot human.
That's not Lulu, let's be clear.
Oh no.
No, it was not a Lulu. It was a in my time of grievance, I chose for it to be a flying elephant, and it was not even remotely close. Nothing can ever, will ever, nor will I ever want it to replace Lulu.
All right. So I do need some action here. What's going down?
I am driving the other thing.
I'm okay. With Silas.
And you guys are driving at the slightly reduced speed?
At the horse speed.
Okay. So go ahead and the drive. So Silas is driving
alone. I'm alone with the unicorn.
And where's Bazit?
Oh yeah, you can take Bazit.
Bazit's in the scavenger. That's fine.
He never moves, so he's with
Bazit's
us.
Bazit's in the scavenger. He will stay there.
Okay.
As Bazit tries to get on the scavenger,
he was already on it.
I mean, I'm just gonna say, do you mind if me and Silas ride alone?
I'm moving. Yep. I'll just. I'm coming.
And don't take no for an answer from Yoll.
Okay. And he kind of gingerly finds his way off the car. Can you just can you show me where the? It's this way, and he just kind of starts wandering in a random direction.
I assume I see it.
Yes.
I'll start yelling at him and go and roll my eyes and go this way just to give him a point of reference.
Marco!
You get one.
Oh, coming! And he runs. And he finds his way onto your vehicle. Okay, so we've got Yoll driving with Bazit and a passed out unicorn. We have and no homunculus. We have the nightmare with Buru and a homunculus, unless you do something different. And we have Gantash, Silas, and two homunculus on the scavenger. All right.
Does that mean that Buru is tandem riding the horse with a homunculus?
Yes.
Getting Shumrath gunk all over him?
A little bit.
It's fine.
Okay. Roll me. Drivers of the cars, roll me a d12. Okay. At your reduced speeds, you rip across the landscape. After about 30 minutes, you look behind you and you can see the demon zapper is long gone. Totally vanished. Not long after that, we'll call it maybe 2 hours total. Yep, sir. Oh, I see. Yeah.
Jump too far ahead there, buddy.
So anyway, 9 hours from now.
No.
Okay.
I want to talk to Silas. No, you're just speeding along.
Well, I'm just saying, you have 2 hours before you even get to the bridge. That's what I was going to say next, so. All right. But you can go ahead and keep doing your thing. Go ahead.
I know it wasn't that long ago. And I said I was going to ask for your aid once more. now I can finally explain. I need you to carry the thumb.
Ooh. Oh.
Why? Is it hindering you?
Yes. And I don't... I don't want the party to lose it.
Why would we lose it?
You in the back.
I'm just worried. And... I was wondering if you would take it.
Hey, insight check him.
Sure. Sure, go ahead and roll insight. Simo, just roll a private through the thing, whatever you need to roll. So if it's truthful, persuasion, if it's not, deception.
Check Discord.
Okay.
Do I use my portent or do I just roll?
You use your portent on me?
Oh.
Holy shit. I bet that's a fucking... It's either
good or bad. Gantash is speaking very contemplatively, and there's something very strange about the way he's like thinking about his answers. He's normally very quick, kind of knows what he's about, but he's taking his time here.
You're not planning on doing something stupid, are you?
Never. Besides, I feel like the thumb fits you more anyway.
Why is that?
Really?
Looks good on me?
Maybe it'll give you more answers for what you seek.
Will it even let you give it to me?
I have a feeling it will.
Sure is doozy. Out of character.
I mean, he doesn't just say that on his horse.
In character, not listening to the conversation, just hanging out with his homunculus and his weird demon horse. Sure is a doozy.
Wait, can I hear that conversation?
No.
Not, yeah.
Yeah, you guys are on ripping.
Dude, if I could hear that conversation, it would be way different.
Yeah, of course.
There's a spear flying in the vehicle. A trident, actually.
Wait, did you get a trident somewhere?
Yes. I have two.
Nice.
You got tridents?
Yeah.
Conversation for another time.
Oh, I remember.
It's been a while.
Oh.
I guess I can hold on to it for a little bit. Just no doing anything stupid.
I won't. And I will, as he's driving, get behind him.
Sure, you don't want to pull over for this?
Grab onto the phone.
Uh-huh.
And cast remove curse.
The figure just kind of stands in front of you, like in front of the vehicle, and it just is like a projection, so it kind of follows you as you go. And as you're about to cast it, you see a big grin come on its face. And you cast Remove Curse. And the rope slackens. And you feel it start rolling up, pulling your hair up. And it drapes forward onto Silas. And as you still hold the thumb, it just pulls your hand in to his back. And then you let go, and it slides its way onto the front of him. Despite the air being hot, hellish, there's an odd sweetness to it as the weight comes off your shoulders. And Silas, this darkness comes into your mind, and you feel like there's a heavy weight on your shoulders now. You have the thumb.
That is not what I thought was going to happen.
This music seems happy, though.
Yeah, it's great. Where's that vampire?
That's another campaign.
This is the music that plays in the bathroom while the vampire's taking a bath after dinner.
Yeah.
They are very happy. God.
Well,
thank you, Silas.
Okay. Yeah. That's it for you guys, or?
Yeah, I'll sit back down.
Okay. You get to the bridge. And if you keep going. So again, it's only been about 2 hours, which by all of your perspectives, you're like, holy shit, why? Last time it was like 8 hours from here. You've also passed through those like mountain ranges. You see the wasp nest, and you just fly through all the scenery. You get to the pit, you rip across the bridge. Anyone, if you've chosen to do anything differently. And the only thing that happens there is you buzz it just briefly in your heads, goes, I can smell it. Don't put me back in there. I'm staying in the car. And you guys tear across the bridge. About 20 minutes later, you find
yourself. Sorry, I have a question real quick. And this is maybe a silly question. Is this like a, time is complicated in Avernus, but is this like a, X amount of hours have passed? But because this is, how like when you're driving home from somewhere, it always feels like the drive is way faster.
Yeah.
Because you like recognize a bunch of stuff and it just like feels like it's way faster. Is it a situation like that, or is it straight up time is passing differently?
It is time is passing differently. Like you've experienced stuff like this in the past.
Okay.
Yeah. But this time, it's time is like, time seems to be going slow and your cars seem to be going very, very fast. And you get to the River Styx at about 2.5 hours.
Sweet. So we're close, really close to the tower then.
Yes.
For no reason whatsoever. How long has it been since we left Mahadi's?
Since you left Mahadi's?
Granted, there's a full roll of long rest in there.
Yeah, I know. Since you left Mahadi's,
eight. So the time from the Demon Zapper to the Crypt of the Hell Riders plus a rest, then back to the Demon Zapper, was 14 hours. So how much time in addition to that has it taken?
So it's an extra 2.5. So you're about 16.5 hours.
Oh fuck. That's a damn shame. Okay.
Okay. So you meet the River Styx. You see it coming. You're about 500 feet away.
We're like close to the quote unquote edge of the River Styx, right? Like, I know it doesn't end because it crosses multiple different planes of existence, but
as far as the map is concerned, yes.
Like the mouth of the River Styx.
This end of it, yeah.
Are there any, like, does it just go on? Or are there, like, portals? Or is it blackness? Or is there, like, what is at this quote-unquote end of the river?
Well, from where you're at, you, it just looks like it just carries on. Like, you see the landscape still, you see... Because you're approximately, you know, where my mouse is here. You're approximately here.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So what do you guys do?
I forget how we got across the bridge, the river last time. Oh, we used Lemon's. We used Silas's super cool wall.
Full of force.
Super cool wall spell.
Do we use that again? So we have no other choice.
Unless you'd rather swim?
Could try swimming.
There's a couple things that I could do with forgetting.
Too bad we don't have a ladder, you know?
Huh. That was so fucking funny. What are the odds, bro?
Yeah, I'll use Wall of Force.
Okay. So you guys are able to
lead.
Okay. So you guys are able to drive over, no problem. It's about one more hour until the edge of the
crater.
Until the edge of the crater.
I'll wait to ask this when we park.
Sure. So you drive up, you can see very clearly there's a dragon perched on top, same white dragon. What do you guys do?
There's still a massive army of undead.
Yep.
Accumulated outside.
Same scene as before. Massive army of undead just kind of wandering. Looks like hundreds. The same pillars coming out of the dirt and sand inside the crater. Just uncovered rocks, basically.
Does the armor look like it's grown?
Not particularly. I mean, it is. It's just droves of them. Skeletons, zombies.
Have we parked at the edge of the crater?
So that's up to that's up to you guys. I just wanted to give you time to kind of think about what you're doing as you're approaching.
Last time it served us well to have a vehicle inside the crater. But we did we leave one? I think we left one outside and we took one inside. We took all of us got in one. I don't think we do that this time. Three vehicles seem sensible.
Just motion to Silas. Let's park on the outside and discuss.
Yes. I'll pull over and get out.
I mean, I'll pull over next time.
Okay.
I'll get out of the scavenger.
And yeah, I'll
and I'll get into drop the down grinder, assess the unicorn again.
Okay. Give me a medicine check.
Not one. I will cast level 2 cure wounds. Let's just see what happens.
Okay. So with your medicine check, you're kind of like rushing, like the adrenaline of the moment is hitting you. You can't really tell what's going on. You cast cure wounds and nothing changes. It wasn't like injured. Doesn't wake up. It just seems like from your medicine check before, it just seemed like it was just exhausted. Like it was just put to work for too long. You need to wear that hat every time. For sure.
I'll get up and then unicorn. It'd be nice to talk to it. We're giving it away, but it's unresponsive. I can't heal it. It needs rest. What valuable information it may have.
The soul. That's the value it holds right now.
You guys are all together. Just, I'm not sure if anyone's not sure where you are. You're all together.
Yeah. Well, let's go get those keys. I'm sure they'll be cordial this time.
Getting old, cold feet. That's a pun because it's a frost strike.
I'll hop in the teaming grinder. After the music stopped, so we died.
Uh-huh.
We all need to go together. Last time we almost died.
We go in with as many as many vehicles as possible. If this turns poorly, no one goes in the same direction.
I have one request. I'm not utterly excited about sacrificing the Celestial. I would like to at least be the one driving it to its destiny.
Sure. Are unicorns celestials?
Yep.
Silas.
Yeah?
Would you like to accompany me?
Why not? Sounds like fun.
You're keeping Bazet, and I'll get out and I'll get in the scavenger.
I'll just say, ah, great. Even if he hears me.
Okay. So you guys roll out?
Bazet right now is kind of like carrying around a suitcase full of dirty laundry. It like will be useful again at some point when you can clean it. But right now, it's just a bag full of useless shit.
Yeah. Okay. So are you guys rolling out then? And just so I am clear, you're in two vehicles. Yoll and Buru.
And a horse.
Oh, and it's okay. So Yoll in scavenger, horse for Buru, and then the other two and the unicorn in the... Okay.
Yeah.
With Bazet.
All right. Let her rip. So also this is just kind of important. Just how fast are you guys gonna rip down this thing?
As we crest over, before we even gain any sort of speed, I would like to cast sending
Are you driving?
It doesn't, I guess.
Don't send and drive, dog.
Don't send and drive. It doesn't require concentration. I'm going to send to crawl. Oh, no, it doesn't. I'm going to send to
crawl. Okay.
I'll say,
we are approaching your tower with the sacrifice for the keys. We don't mean harm.
And he sends back,
I can see you. Bring it. Nothing funny.
I can't respond, so.
Okay. So I'll ask again, how fast are you ripping down here? Are you full tilt or?
I'm gonna go slow. Okay. I'm gonna go slowish. I don't need to go fast.
Pretty steep, okay. Right?
So it'll take a few minutes to get down there. Yeah, it's a. I mean, it's not super steep. It is like a crater. You know, you guys were able to drive out of it before, but I'll say it takes a couple minutes to get down there. And the droves of undead are kind of like all pointed in your direction and like wavering and stuff like that. Okay, just one sec. Okay. So you guys make your way down, and as you get about a minute away, so you drive down about 3 minutes, you get about a minute away, the undead start kind of parting themselves in order to kind of make a clearing, a pretty wide one. And the doors to the tower open up, and at the bottom of the tower, you see Krull and Archon and a young dragon. It is red, and it just walks its way out smoothly behind Archon and Krull. You guys make your way forward, and I am actually going to... I'm going to send a couple messages at this point, because there's a couple things that are going to happen here. So unfortunately, I do have to send them via messages. So just give me half a second and I will get that done as quickly as possible. So just keep an eye on your DMs just in case. Okay. All right, so you make your way forward, and they kind of stand stoically with the dragon behind them. Dragon seems kind of on edge, like it's basically ready to strike. It's got its teeth gnarled. And the Krull kind of steps forward. Do you guys stop your cars?
Yes, I will. I'm driving the demon right now.
Okay. And Yoll?
Yep.
Some new gifts. It looks like you've been out for a while. No worry to me. What did you bring?
And he like, and you see him just kind of like pause, and he kind of like stands up a little bit straighter, and you just see him kind of like look around a little bit. And then he kind of looks at each one of you in the face.
And I'll get out of the car. Step out of the demon grinder. Brought what you ask. Held up our end of the bargain.
Can I get a perception check from Yoll, Buru, and Silas?
Oh boy.
15.
Okay. Simo, you have to send me something here.
Oh.
Yeah.
love Viking music.
Buru and Yoll, you can see out of your peripheral vision as Gantash is getting down. He looks like a little different, and then you're like, what's going on here? And you look, you see that his bag and his weapon is on the floor of the demon grinder. Silas, you hear those items hit the floor. And as you do so, Krull kind of like looking around, and then he like locks eyes with Gantash. And you see this sinister grin come over his face. He says, I suppose you aren't everything I suspected you to be. And he turns around and he goes to talk to Archon. So he takes about 10 steps back. And you see he kind of converses in a hushed tone. And then you see that same grin come on Archon's face. And Krull just turns around, doesn't walk forward towards you anymore. And he says, we accept. Bring your offering.
We'll go over to the demon grinder.
You will?
Mm-hmm. I'll get out of the scavenger, go over to the demon grinder.
Okay.
Look at Buru.
I'm just gonna start walking forward.
I will, I guess, get off my nightmare and assist Yoll.
As you guys go to pick up the unicorn, you can see the, we'll call it approximately 80 feet distance. Gantash has closed about half of that, and he's walking forward as you're about to lift the unicorn. And you just hear,
you boys, rest your backs today. Not everything about your plan seems to have been communicated.
Gantash, you fucking idiot.
I have a mind link of 110 feet. Right before I get out of range, I'll just say to every... I'll mind link with each of them before I get out of range. Just say for glory. And then the range.
Who do you say that to?
Everybody. Just one at a time. Connect, connect, connect. And then I'll be out of range. Can link it if you want. I don't know.
Wait. Do we even have time to react to this?
I'm going to say he's 80 feet. I'll say he's like 50 feet away. So he's closer now to them. He's 30 feet from them, 50 feet from you. And you... Yeah. I'll give you guys a minute to think about what you want to do. We'll stay frozen in this moment for a second.
Yeah, kind of been forced into a situation here.
Yeah, with zero... I mean, I guess there was.
Bro, I knew since the goddamn crypt. And there, I can stop you right now.
But, oh my god.
This is weirdly, like, very fitting music.
Know how to pick it.
Yeah, you really do. The right man for the job.
What the fuck are we supposed to do with the unicorn?
I know, right? That's why I'm like, do we...
That's his new character.
Like, we have just... This is actively making... We made a deal to help someone, and then we're making it a massive pain in the ass to fulfill that promise that we made to help them, for them to promise to help us. But then we still have the thing that they helped us with, but it's not useful to us anymore. So it's like paying someone $100 for the corner piece to a puzzle that you already have.
Only for the corner piece to set your house on fire somehow. Oh, boy.
I mean, I'll look over to Yoll and Buru. And I'll say... Should we do something about this? Do you want me to stop him?
I just want to pause and say this is the fucking best moment ever. I'm so fucking excited for anything that happens from here on out. All right. Anyways, carry on. I was exploding inside. I just wanted you to know.
I'm thrilled for you.
Thanks.
Stop him.
Well, Yoll.
Hard because I don't actually know what Yoll would do.
Brew would 100% stop this. I just don't want to kill everybody in the process. Oh,
couldn't kill everybody. I'm going to make the call, since no one's making the call. I can cast this up to 120 feet.
I'm going to yell to Gantash.
Okay.
That he forgot to give back he forgot something. I'm going to call him back.
He forgot something, bro. Wait.
So Silas, I just need to know, are you like, so Buru starts yelling, like you're thinking about casting the spell. Buru starts yelling.
I'll wait until.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to be clear too. You have about 10 feet out on either side, and it travels about 40 feet behind you. You have this army of undead on either side of you. Just to be clear.
I hear Buru. Stop moving forward towards them, the Archon and Roll. And Buru hears in his mind, made my choice. And he keeps walking forward.
Can I communicate back to him with the mind link?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What are you doing? This is selfish. What of this horse, this unicorn, this creature we picked up?
It will help you.
I have one horse already. I don't need a second one. What are you doing?
What I feel is right.
You're going to die. Do you have other plans than dying? Do you have something up your sleeve?
I'm already dying. Might as well be for a good cause.
I'm going to run up to Gantash. And with my arms in the air.
Hold on. Whoa. You're like 60 feet away. I can react to you running towards me.
Yeah, you can. So you can start running. Sure. Hands in the air. The undead army, as you start running, the undead army you see kind of stiffens and they all watch you. Hundreds of heads just turn and watch you running. What do you do, Gantash?
I look back to him and cast command.
Oh, fuck you. Oh. This dirty motherfucker.
Wisdom saving throw, please.
Wisdom saving throw. Jesus Christ.
Okay.
Privately.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on. What are you?
Uh-huh. Okay. Oh. Go ahead.
But do you know if you fail it yet?
Are you allowed to use it? You failed.
The condition is that you have failed it.
Yeah, you failed it.
Okay, so you can use it again.
What do you command?
Flee.
And you run towards him, and your feet betray you, and they turn you, and you start running away.
Okay, wait. Hold the fucking phone here. There's gotta be something.
No phone to be held. You just got God, my brother.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Our way. Fuck. Is there really nothing I can do?
Gantash, what do you do?
I stopped to respond to him, and throughout this encounter, I've still been continuing walking forward.
Okay.
I would like to address Krull.
Okay.
A deal's a deal. The rods. And then I'll look down at Gantash for a fool.
And you can see Krull kind of like looks to Archon as Gantash is getting closer, and Archon raises his kind of green decrepit hand. And he like holds his hand out, and you see it just instinctually kind of like forms a finger and points towards Gantash. And he kind of nods his head.
Sorry, we had to check the goods, see if they were still intact.
And he just kind of like lets out a little whistle. And two more young dragons come out from behind, and they have the rods half strapped to each of their backs, and they kind of lumber forward, carrying them out to your vehicle. By this point, so I know Silas, you've been kind of like finger on the trigger, like waiting to do something. So I'll let you, like, if that's still what you want to do, you can do that whenever you're thinking of doing it. Or
no,
you're not gonna do it. Okay, so the dragons make their way out and they bring them over to your demon grinder. And they just kind of like crawl up on top of your demon grinder and slide them down their wings. So they kind of like cross way across your demon grinder, and they just find kind of haphazard resting spots, basically above the unicorn. Like they're kind of caught in between the seats and the harpoon flingers, and they just almost like a, like if you made a shelter out of sticks. That's kind of my best imagery for that. And Gantash keeps walking forward while they do that, and they kind of swap spots. The two dragons walk past you, and Archon puts his good hand around your back and walks you in towards the ramp. And Krull stays outside. He looks at each of you as the two dragons join him, joined by his side.
Now just the three. Let's hope these do you some good. We've learned a thing or two about you. Believe it or not, your success could be ours. So use these fucking things. Oh, and you might want to stick around for the show. Don't go too far.
What are you gonna do to him?
If you don't know that by now, then I've lost all faith in you.
Assuming what you're gonna do is different from what you're going to tell us. Tell us what you're going to do. Help us understand.
We'll feed him a nice dinner. Oh, sorry, I thought you wanted me to lie to you. He's probably on the second floor now. And then the third. And if you wait long enough, you'll get to the fifth and the sixth. And then you'll see him on that balcony up there.
And you look up, and there is indeed a small semicircular balcony that juts out from an opening in the front of the tower. Inside the tower, Gantash, he silently walks you up around the spiral, hastily heading towards each of the ramps. And he feels powerful as he kind of pushes you along. He's not very tall necessarily, but he is powerful, and he pushes you along wordless.
Can I try a few things?
Sure.
Gonna try to read his mind. See where that gets me.
Okay. Wisdom save?
Yeah.
Good luck. It's a 24.
Holy shit. Okay. And I'll just throw divine intervention out there too. Might as well.
Okay. It's an instant cast thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Now this you really need luck for.
I'm gonna roll it in a...
Okay, say just tell me low or high.
What
low
does
or
it
high.
Do?
Allows my deity to intervene.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's a 11% chance that it'll work.
I'm gonna right, say well. Low.
Low? Okay. You search your soul for a response from Torm. You think you see your rings glow, but nothing happens. That would have been the most insane shit of all time, though.
Worth a shot, you know?
Yeah. You lose track of how many floors you've kind of wandered up as you're throwing these things out. Is there anything else you'd like to do?
I'm just going to be praying to Torm. Whole time. Nothing else I'd really like to do. Just kind of clasping my ring, spinning it around.
The rings, you feel a warmth come from them, and they kind of gently force your hand into a fist. And then it forces your hand open into the symbol of Torm. And Archon guides you out onto a balcony. For you down below, you see up Archon and Gantash on the balcony as they approach the edge. And with his good hand, he grabs you, Gantash, by the neck, and he looks at you. He says, you know, in another life, we might have fought alongside each other. I'm sure someone's proud of you. And he holds you out over the edge. And with his other hand, he grips your face with these long, spindly fingers. And you just feel the tips of them on your cheeks and your forehead. And as all of you look up, you see the life being sucked out of Gantash as his body shrivels. And just before he's let go, this plume of white spores pour out of his face. And it catches Archon off guard, and he kind of stumbles back, dropping Gantash in the process. And the body falls hundreds of feet, crashing directly in front of Krull. And that's where we're going to call it. That session felt like 5 hours. In a good way.
Great music.